Hello, everybody, and welcome. My name is Bennett Tchaikovsky, and welcome to Financial Statement Analysis Part 1. So my disclaimer and copyright notice, the information and opinions in this presentation are those of the author only and not the author's employers or affiliated organizations, including but not limited to Irvine Valley College and the South Orange County Community College District. The presentation is for educational purposes only and does not constitute any legal or accounting advice whatsoever. This presentation is copyright 2008-2022 by Bennett Tchaikovsky. All rights are reserved. Any distribution is strictly prohibited. So one of the things that I try to do if I have the time and the bandwidth when I am teaching is to have my intermediate accounting students and or my managerial accounting honors students complete a paper. And the general premise behind the paper and kind of the reason why I have them do this is that when a student starts looking at publicly traded companies, they're getting additional exposure to the Securities and Exchange Commission's website to look up financial statements. And this is extremely important because if you were starting a job as an auditor, or as an analyst, whatever it might be, you will be spending a lot of time and you should be spending a lot of time on that website. It's also going to give something for the student to discuss during interviews. I can't tell you the amount of feedback I've had from prior students when they're able to go through and say, yes, I did a paper comparing these two different publicly traded companies. I really got a lot out of it. So, and when you kind of start talking about the paper on the interview, we'd say, well, I chose these ratios and these are the different ratios that I had to go through and compute. So it's something that really gives the student an opportunity to, you know, use in their later careers. We're also going to be using, or my students will be using, Google Sheets or Microsoft Excel. I just prefer Google Sheets. It's nothing against Excel. Pretty much the same thing, but using collaborative sheets, especially when you're going to be going in public accounting, when there are a lot of collaborative sheets running around, because that's really how most all work is getting done. And then also, it's not just when you're teaching ratios or financial statement analysis. Most students will just look at the numbers and they will just go through and, you know, copy down a ratio. It's not that, that's not the way you want to do it. You have to look at every individual company and see which company is, you know, what ratio is important to one company versus another company. The example that I continuously will give, and we can just kind of take a little look at this really quickly, is if I look at the Home Depot. And if we go to the Home Depot, and when we look at their quarterly report for the Home Depot, give you a great example. When we look at ratios, one of the things that you're going to see is that there is a ratio. If I go to investopedia.com, which is a great website. So if we say over here, AR turnover counts. So receivables turnover. What is the receivables turnover? It's how efficient is a company in collecting its accounts receivable. Another one is going to be inventory turnover ratio. Over here, how to calculate it. It's essentially going to be calculating it is going to be the cost of goods sold divided by the average inventory. So how many times is your inventory turning over per year? And this is something that's very important, especially if you're an electronics retailer. So if I give a student those two ratios and I say, well, which one is better to use for the Home Depot? This requires an additional step because most students, when they learn this, they say, oh, here's the ratio. I'm going to go through and compute it. When you're writing a paper, it's a little bit different because when you're writing a paper, you're really required to say, well, wait a second. Which one of these two items is more materially significant to the company? And if I look it over here, well, inventory or receivables is about 3.5 billion of 73 billion, roughly going to be about maybe 4 to 5% of total assets. But merchandise inventories at $20 billion is a very significant amount of total assets. So if we had to choose between the inventory turnover and the accounts receivable turnover ratio, we would choose the inventory turnover ratio because of the significance of this from a quantitative analysis only. So again, this is why when you give a ratio to a student, or you can go through and churn out a bunch of ratios, but when it really comes to analyzing a company, you want to try to find things that are going to be most relevant to the company. Another example while we're here is when we look at the Home Depot, what you're going to notice is they have debt, surprisingly, but they have debt. And between their current installments of long-term debt of $2.4 billion and long-term debt excluding current installments of $36 billion, this is upwards of roughly of about $39 billion of debt. Okay, so that's how much debt Home Depot has taken on. So when we look at this taking on of debt, that also kind of comes up to say, well, is there a concern here with can the company pay interest? And if we look at the ratio of times interest earned, and when we look at times interest earned ratio, what this tells us is how well, which is really, I believe that what you're doing is you're going through and taking basically calculating EBITDA and then essentially going through and comparing this to, you know, how much coverage do you have or that ability to repay debt. So that's something that's extremely important. However, Home Depot has debt. But if I go and look at a company like Meta Platforms, and if we pull up their 10K and I look at Meta Platforms, we go to their financial statements, we look at their balance sheets, you do not see any type of debt. Okay, so over here, accounts payable, partners payable, those are really payable liabilities, accrued expenses and other current liabilities, that is not debt. So a company like Facebook, that times interest earned ratio is inapplicable. So as we go through, and this is really the importance of learning about, you know, as we're going through and doing this, it's really seeing which ratios are going to be the most important or meaningful to a company. And this is really, as a student, this is what's extremely important that I really want you to leave this class with, is that when you're looking at financial statements, you have to not just, you know, go through and compute ratios. You have to be able to say, well, which ratios are most meaningful for this particular company? Okay, so usually what I will do in my classes is I create a list of companies. What I try to go through and do every semester is I try to find the ones that are really distressed, either from a stock price or something else, just because that's what I enjoy looking at. You know, I can, it's easier to do an analysis of somebody that's healthy, but when you see somebody that's going to be a little bit more distressed, so I go out there and I choose the different companies. And like what I will typically do is that my students will come over here, and what they'll do is they'll take a look, and let me go back over here. So right over here, what I'll do is I will list out all these different companies, and students will have the opportunity to go through and to select them. So they'll select a company, and that will be their first responsibility to do. I usually will have them like list out four different ones, just because in going through and doing the company selections, there may be different times where you'll basically will go through and you'll see different things popping up. So when we're going through and doing now, here's the challenge. When you are looking at how to find a comparable publicly traded company. So why do I want you to have choose two companies? Why is that important to me? It's because if I look at a company just on its own, that's not going to give me a really good perspective. I have to look at it in the context of a company that's in a similar industry. Now, for certain companies like GameStop, that's going to be a harder one to do. Why? Because GameStop has a lot of smaller little stores that are might be stores within stores, but they have, it's not something where they're really comparable. One of my students is doing it right now. She's using Best Buy. And so that's a good one to look at. But when you look at some companies, it can actually be kind of difficult to do, because if you say like, well, Netflix versus Disney, are they comparable? Well, I would say that both of them produce original content that Disney shows now on Disney Plus, and Netflix has their, obviously their own platform. But Netflix does not operate theme parks. Of course, they've got Squid Games now. That sounds a little dark. But again, Red Light, Green Light, you know, Hopscotch, those fun games have taken on a whole new meaning because of that show. But they do not yet have a theme park. So could you compare Netflix and Disney? I don't really think it's a good comparison. What about Netflix versus Amazon? Well, we know that Amazon has Amazon Prime. They recently, I think, are in the process of acquiring MGM. So that kind of makes them somewhat similar, but at the same time, does Netflix have grocery stores or offer web services? And the answer is no, they don't offer those types of things. So when you going through and trying to find a comparable publicly traded company, that is something that can be sometimes challenging to do. But where is the best place for us to go to and try to go through and look? Well, the first place we can go through and look, and this is why, you know, looking at publicly traded companies can be so valuable, is we can come over here. Let's take a look at our meta platforms. Okay, so, and let's go to the 10K of Meta, right? This is formerly known as Facebook, right? So over here, if we say competition, okay. So right over here, our business is characterized by innovation, rapid change, disruptive technologies. We compete with companies providing connection, sharing discovery. We face significant competition in every aspect of our business, including but not limited to basically over here, like Alphabet, Google, and YouTube, Amazon, Apple, ByteDance, Microsoft, Snap, Tencent, Twitter. So what you kind of look at this over here is that this is where you would really want to start in terms of trying to find the competition, because as a publicly traded company, when you file your 10K, you have to talk a lot about your business. And when you look at this over here, there's a lot of information about Facebook that can be found from this. And this is yet again another reason why I want you to, you know, if you're doing this on your own, or if you're going through and taking my class, this is really why I want you to go through and to do this, because you're going to be exposed to, oh, here's the competition. Now, for myself, when I'm going through and doing this, I'm probably going to choose Twitter to do the comparison. And part of the reason is that Google has a lot more in terms of search engines. And obviously with YouTube, I would want to kind of say that for Facebook, I would want to make Twitter like a little bit, I think it might be a little bit of an easier comparison. But and again, when you're going through, and one of the things that I'll ask you to do is, as my student, is when you're going through and, you know, this is an example is over here, So after your company select, you'll find need to find a comparable publicly traded company. So enter the company here and explain why or why not you chose the company. So what I would probably say here is that for my response, because I'm really going through and doing this over here for Facebook. So Facebook, so my company selected is Meta Platforms. A comparable company would be Twitter. Okay, and why is that company, you know, Twitter? Twitter has a lot, or Twitter has a significant. Twitter is a platform for social engagement, while Facebook has offers some similar attributes in its business model. Additionally, Facebook identifies Twitter as a competitor. Right, so you're never going to find two companies that are exactly alike. But if I'm asking you to go through for my class, to go through and identify, okay, why did you choose this company? And, you know, you chose a company, one that I generally selected for you, but you chose from that list. But when it comes to the competition, I'm going to want to know, well, why did you choose it? Right? Don't say, well, both Facebook and Twitter banned Trump. So that's probably true, but you can't say that. It's really more of like, well, the more proper answer, actually that is true, but actually, which is very sad, right over here, I don't want to have speech hindered for anybody. Okay, so over here, our business is going down over here is we look at this and it's identified as, you know, as a potential, as a competitor to Facebook. So again, when we look at this over here, this is what we kind of want to try to go through and say. So just kind of say briefly why you think it's a competitor. And then you can also say, yeah, Facebook identified Twitter as a competitor. So this is the first part of the project, which is going to be identifying that company, as well as going through and talking about why did you select this as a comparable company. I do not need, if you're taking my class, I don't need a huge explanation, but rather just a just something that's brief. So in any event, I want to thank you for joining me here today. If there are any other videos that you would like to see, please feel free to go through and leave a comment. Just one other thing is, like, if you're not in my class, right? So if you're looking at this video and you're new to my channel and you want to do this on your own at home, please feel free to leave a comment. And if you leave a comment, what I'll do is I'm not going to grade your work, but I will say, oh yeah, that sounds like a good comparable company. So feel free to go through and to do that. And if you want to kind of go through and complete this project as I go through and do it, you're more than welcome to do so. But thank you so much for joining me today. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. And I look forward to seeing you on the next video. Have a great day.